I actually really like Norwich. I think they're a very smart young club. They've got a director of football at the minute.
Stuart Webber.
Yeah. Really, really, really good. Knows exactly what he's doing. He's got a similar outlook on squad building to what we've preached on this pod. Just very smart recruitment. When he got promoted, he basically had the option to either do a Fulham or use the promotion funds to tie down your big stars on long deals so that you're going to make long-term profits on those and bring in a few bargains here and there, really. They very quickly got onto the fact that farming might be available. So they got a loan. That's a clever deal for me. Damage, I think he's had some injury issues, but on a free transfer, again, makes sense. Patrick Roberts from City, financial costs, there's virtually nothing there. He's on a loan. Sam Bynum, I don't think he's going to start by any means, but I think he's just another means of getting cover for very little funds. But I think if you look at Norwich's squad, I think three of the four defenders that play for Norwich in the first team are going to fetch really big sums, I think, in the next couple of seasons. You've got Max Ahrens, Jamal Lewis and Ben Godfrey. I think the oldest out of them three is 21. They're all really upcoming, progressive, the kind that go for 50-odd million, usually. You know, whether Norwich go up or go down at the end of the season. I wouldn't surprise me at all if at least two of them got snapped up next summer after getting exposure in the Premier League. So, yeah, Stuart Webber's, you know, really, really strong director of football. Knows what he's doing, worked his way up from the bottom. And he's in charge of the whole transfer thing, and he's the reason that they haven't signed a great deal of players, but he's thinking long term, which is the right way to go about it for me. They're very much a 4-2-3-1 team under Falke, but again, against Liverpool away at Anfield, they couldn't have wished for a worse opening fixture there. I don't think they'll be expecting to get anything from it by any means, and if they're going to keep their principles intact and play the same way, could be a cricket score. But that's, again, that's no real knock on Norwich because I like what they're doing. It's just not a good opening fixture for them, I'd say.
Pookie, who's their Finnish striker, he was second in the championship last season in terms of expected goals and assists combined. But then you've got Hernandez and Buendia, 25th and 26th with the next in for Norwich. Don't get me wrong, they were both posting around 15 goals/assists a season. I think that just maybe shows as well that there's still that little bit of a gap. Pookie is the main man.
I think Buendia is definitely worth watching. He's only about like 5'6", I think. He's very small, really, really creative technical player. If you look at his expected assists per 90, he posted a figure that was, if it was in the Premier League, only 6 players last season with over 1,500 minutes posted better and posted a more creative figure per 90. It's going to be a case of if you keep him quiet, you'll do a lot to stop Norwich's attack. Him being in a more technical league now, it'll be interesting to see how he does. He's only 22. He's the type to develop, you know, a bit of a following if he starts performing. He usually plays on the right, so it'd be Robertson's case. Or he's played minutes on the left as well. And with Trent being that slightly more defensively problematic, obviously you get him away from Van Dijk as well, it wouldn't surprise me if I put him on the left. He's just a talent that's worth looking at for the season and for the match at Anfield, but I'd say more so for the season, he's interesting, he'd be worth following.